Hey, what's up, everybody? I want to share with you guys something out of Mark chapter 1 today. I want to talk to you about prayer, and specifically in the life of Jesus and how he modeled a life of prayer for us and for his disciples that really caught their attention. So first, I want to just look at a passage in Mark 1. We're going to pick up in verse 32 if you want to follow along or anything like that. But we see that Jesus is starting out his ministry at the beginning. This is the beginning of his ministry, and he's starting out. And he's in the city of Capernaum. Okay, so he has been teaching, and he had been doing different things, casting out demons and healing people. And he goes to his disciples' house, Simon Peter and Andrew. He goes to their house, right? And it says in verse 32, it says that evening at sundown, they brought to him all who were sick or oppressed by demons. And the whole city was gathered together at the door. And he healed many who were sick with various diseases and cast out many demons, and he would not permit the demons to speak because they knew him. So he's been doing ministry, and he comes to his disciples' house, and he's kind of getting away a little bit. All of a sudden, the whole city shows up to his house. I mean, can you imagine that? Like, I don't know how big the city of Capernaum was, but it had to be some hundreds, maybe even thousands of people all showed up at Jesus' door, and he ends up, he's casting out demons, healing the sick, right? Healing many, all the people that were coming to his door, right? And so we even see, like, so the prayer meeting goes deep into the night, right? It probably went on very long. But in verse 35, it says, "And rising very early in the morning, while it was still dark, he departed and went out to a desolate place, and there he prayed." So he had just spent the last evening, gone on for hours, him healing the sick and casting out demons. Then the next morning, while it was still dark, he rises early to go and to pray. And man, that's crazy. That was such a priority that even at, the ministry that he had done, it probably was tiresome, but it was still important to him to get up in the next morning and connect with the Lord in prayer, connect with the Father. And so, you know, we can read on. It says, "Simon Peter and those who were with him searched for him, and they found him, and they said to him, 'Everyone is looking for you.'" So Simon Peter comes to them, and he's like, "Hey, listen, Jesus, there's still a lot of people. They're all looking for you. There's still much. There's much opportunity for ministry." And Jesus, if you read on, he goes on to say, "Actually, you know, we're going to move on to the next city." But it's very interesting that there was so much more opportunity for ministry, like Simon Peter said. But Jesus had more important things to do. Not only was it more important to him to pray, but it was time to move on. And so we see him giving up this ministry opportunity to do the will of the Father. And not first to give up opportunity for ministry to go and pray, because there was lots of people waiting for him to come back outside, but he snuck off to pray. But also, it was time to move on. So we kind of see this same heart of Jesus in Luke chapter 10 when he's with Mary and Martha, right? He says to Martha, who is serving and doing ministry, he says, "Martha, you are worried and anxious about many things, but Mary, who is sitting at my feet, she's doing the one thing that is necessary." So we kind of see that same heart of God, that how it's more important to him to sit at the feet of God than it is to do ministry or to serve, right? So we see throughout the Gospels that Jesus lived in prayer, and that he even gave up ministry opportunities to pray and connect with the Father. You can just, if you read the Gospels, you will find over and over and over that Jesus went away by himself to connect with the Lord. We even see, I think it's Luke chapter, let me see real quick. Yeah, it's Luke chapter 6, verse 12, where Jesus actually prayed all night long. So it was very important to him. And so he modeled this life of prayer for his disciples, and it was so intriguing to them that finally in Luke chapter 11, they come to him and they're like, "Jesus, teach us how to pray. We want to know, like, what do you know about connecting with the Father? This is so intriguing to us." And Jesus goes on to teach them what it looks like to pray. But it's very interesting that they all throughout Jesus' life, the disciples never asked him, "Jesus, will you teach us how to preach?" All right? And you would think that's pretty important. Like, Jesus did a lot of preaching and teaching. But what they were most intrigued about was, "Jesus, would you teach us how to pray? We can see how important it is to you in your life. We want it to be important in ours." And so I think we can take something from the disciples and learn from them and see, okay, cultivating a life of prayer was important to Jesus, number one. And the disciples could see that, and so they were very intrigued, and they asked. They wanted it to be important in their lives. I think it could be way more important to us, and I think we should see how important it is to Jesus and his heart to connect with the Father. And so let's start cultivating a life of prayer. That's my encouragement. Have a great day, guys. See you later.